I think it's incredible. The devil can quote scripture like we can't believe. But sometimes when we see people that are doing stuff that's really wrong, we don't find out why they're doing it or what their side of the argument is. So we know how to love them. Because we're called to love everybody, amen? We're not like hate people that have different viewpoints than us. It's better to try to understand them. So there's a time to listen. Then there's a time to speak. Time to speak. Did you know something? They think it's about 50, 60 years away that nobody in America will say, I love you anymore. Did you know that? Most of us will be born. It's 60 years away in America, nobody will say, I love you anymore. Less and less people say, I love you. In counselors' offices, it's going up daily. The amount of people that are coming in, she'll never say, I love you. People never say, I love you. You never say, I love you. Give me kids who've never heard, I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you. I just want to take this time to tell you, I am proud. You know what I mean? Kids have not heard no. No. Everybody in America under 10, typically bring their kids in bed. I'm just kidding. No, but seriously, you go to a lot of places and you can see these kids have never said no, heard no, right? Small kids. My sister's a third grade teacher. She said the only time they hear no is when they're in school. Okay? You know what I'm saying? That's the only shaking their head. Yes. No. You won't say no. And there are times to speak. There are times that God desires us. And so we have to know that there's different times. There's times for listening and times for speaking. And we go through these seasons, but as we do them, it is important that we need to learn to recognize when a season is ending. We need to understand when a season is ending. Because there are changes. So in doing this, we're going to look at a few ways of knowing how to do these things, the seasons, to help you get through. And the first thing I want you to do is identify your season. Identify the season that you're in. You may be in a season of sadness. And if you are, pray to God, ask Him to help you through it, and learn to go through your season. You're in a season of happiness, enjoy it. Pray and ask God to thank God over and over for the time that you have to tap. You know, if it's a time that you need to listen more, pray. If it's a time that you need to speak more, pray. If it's a time you need to throw things away, whatever, identify your season. And the second thing to do that we don't look at most is when you're in a season, what does God want to teach you? What does God want to teach you in this season? Everything that we're doing is a learning thing. We are preparing for the kingdom of heaven. That's all life is. So what are we learning from this season? What are we doing? You know, I gotta tell you. I went into the ministry and I had people dying all the time in hospice and everything. And I tried to go and love and help people and everything. And you know, just do me in. But you hear people come in all the time and say, I know what you're going through. Didn't know what they were going through. My family was pretty death free. Then all of a sudden, I did my mom and dad. I watched the doctor, I watched the cancer paper, watched it. You know what? And it changed me like you can't believe in the ability to love people, love families, know what everyone's feeling like, how to take care of people, do this thing. And although it was a terrible season that I wouldn't want to do anything, it was an extreme training session that we got on how to love people. And take care of them and how it feels and what to know. And so as you're in that, what does God want to teach you? And the third thing, live in your season. Live in your season. Live in your season. Just live in it. No, ask God to get me out of the season, but live in it. Just know that life is moving on. Know that the season is going. quit. Don't throw your hands if you're somewhere and sit down and say, it's over. It's easy to quit. Continue to live in your season. And number four is be prepared for an end. Be ready for the season to end. It's going to stop. I said before, if you're in a period of great sadness, you're going to get happy. If you're in a period of great happiness, something's going to happen to make you sad. And you don't know when, you don't know how, you don't know what, but just be prepared. And as soon as it ends, what do? You go back to the beginning of the list. Identify your season. What does God want to teach you? Okay? Live in your season. And as you're doing that, be prepared for it. And then go back to start the list again. Philippians 4:8 says this. Finally, my friends, keep your minds on whatever is true, pure, right, holy, friendly, and proper. And don't ever stop thinking about what is truly worthwhile and worthy of praise. As we're going through this, think about the things that are of God. Don't ever stop thinking about what is truly worthwhile and worthy of praise. God. Focus on God in a happy season. Focus on God in a sad season. Focus on God and think, Lord, do I really need to keep this? Lord, it's okay that I throw this away. Lord, should I trust this person? Lord, is this person a bad influence on me? Looking at all those things and staying focused on Him. And then going to the final season. The final season we all look at is the season of our death. The season of our death. If you're going to be born, there's a time to be born, there's a time to die. And unless we're here when the Lord comes back, we're all going to have our physical bodies die. And it's going to happen. But you know what? Know your eternity. That's what gets us through the season of death. Understanding that we won't die. If we have the promise of Jesus Christ and we believe that with all of our hearts, we will never die. It totally changes the season of death. It makes it completely different. We understand that we won't die. It changes how the season is felt. It changes how the season is met. It changes with how we deal with the season. But in order to do that, we have to trust God. Trust God. And it's one of the things sometimes we fall short. It's a lot easier to trust ourselves than to trust God. It's a lot easier to trust a doctor, trust a bank, or a financial advisor, somebody like that. It's a lot easier to trust them than it is to trust God. Because there's times we're just not always 100% sure God's really there. And we're not always 100% sure that God really loves us. Amen? Think about it. The last time you said, God, why are you doing this to me? Right? Right? You really love me? Why are you doing this to me? Man. No, it's sure we trust God. Ecclesiastes 3, 9 through 14. What do we gain by all of our hard work? I have seen what difficult things God demands of us. God makes everything happen at the right time, yet none of us can ever fully understand all He has done, and He puts questions in our minds about the past and future. I know the best thing we can do is to always enjoy life, because God's gift to us is the happiness we get from our food and drink and from the work we do. Everything that God has done will last forever. Nothing He does can ever be changed. God has done all this so that we will worship God makes everything happen at the right time. You can have faith in Him. To know whatever your season is, you need to get right now. God makes everything happen at the right time. So knowing that, enjoy life. Enjoy life. Jesus says in the scriptures, basically, this is Dan Brown translation, but it's accurate. He says that once you see the empty tomb, nothing will ever be able to take the smile off your face again. You know that? Once you see the empty tomb, nothing will ever be able to take the smile off your face again. Why would he say that? Death is defeated. What's our number one fear? Death. Number one fear? We can die. going to take this moment off your hands? What's going to make you feel like enjoy life? People say, well, based on what we're going through, based on what's happening, how do you expect us to enjoy life? And I'm going to tell you right now, the reason you can enjoy life is because God is in charge. You're not in charge. We all want to be in charge. I want to be in charge. Anybody else in here want to be in charge? Because if I was in charge of all time, if I was in charge of somebody really deflated the footballs, I would look down and overinflate them so that the guy couldn't get his hands on the throne and fall out all the time, and then the receiver's hands would bounce out. I'd put helium in the cup. So when they got the snap, they threw him and just keep one up in the air. That's what I'd do if I was God. I'd be having a good time. All right? I know what I'd do if I was in charge, but you know what? So does he. That's why he didn't put me in charge. That's why he's in charge. And I have to know each day as I live, he is in charge. He is in charge of what's going to happen. So just enjoy the ride. Learn to live in that trust. The question comes is, can you let Jesus get you through the season? Can you do that? Can you trust him? Can you trust him to get through the season? There's a lot of people that have left following Christ because of seasons. Did you know that? Little things have happened in their lives. People went down an illness. People went back. I'll tell you what. I knew a guy one time that in 1998, you ever knew who doesn't even follow Christ anymore because the white kids didn't have. He walked on. He needed the hope that he needed to get through that Y2K thing because the world in 2000 didn't want him anymore. But can you trust Jesus to get you through all your seasons? Put him in charge? To be there with him? To just enjoy life, whatever it be, whatever it be. Just go through and realize it's part of what he has planned. He's going to take whatever this is and make it to glorify him because that's what he wants. He wants everybody to worship. So in some way, somehow, it's going to work out to glorify him. If you want that in your life today, if you have not had Jesus Christ in your life, and you want to be a follower without the invitation, you can come today and pray and ask him to come into your life and take charge of your season. If you just need prayer.